EA in the 2000s was everybody's favorite game developer. From games like Madden 08, which was regarded as the best Madden of all time, to The Sims 3, which was revolutionary in the gaming world, Electronic Arts was proving to be an amazing company. They cared about their fans and their game. Over the years, though, they started to forget about all of the loyal fans that they gained, and they forgot about making quality video games. The company who was focused on players and quality started to focus on money. This is never good in any situation. Forgetting about your supporters and your product? This couldn't possibly have a good ending. And it didn't. EA went downhill. Before we dive more into why they went downhill, we need to focus on what made them fail. Let's focus on the Madden football franchise, for example. Madden 2001 to Madden 2008 was the glory days. The games were as great as the console's storage would let them be. The graphics continued to get better throughout the years as well as the gameplay. This showed that they cared about their game, and every year we had something new to look forward to. But this changed, and EA turned into a monster. More specifically, a money-hungry monster. Madden 10 through Madden 19 was crap. They introduced their ultimate money grab. ultimate team game mode. And that's when the Madden franchise went bad. EA made no money other than sales from the game from 2001 to 2012. But with the introduction of Ultimate Team, it made them a serious amount of money that nobody thought they could gain. Not even them. Once this money started coming in, they started focusing on Ultimate Team. At the same time, they were forgetting about the franchise mode, the game mechanics, and just the rest of the game in general. The only thing that was good with Madden was Ultimate Team, and that's because it made EA money, so they put their time into making that game mode amazing. So everyone makes mistakes, right? This was only one game franchise that was ruined. Let's see if they happen to have done similar things to any of their other games. For example, in Star Wars Battlefront 2, EA made it excessively difficult to unlock main characters. Most people who buy these games are fans of these Star Wars movies, and all they want to do within the game is just play as their favorite character from the movies. But to unlock Darth Vader, which is a very popular character, you needed to play 40 hours on the game. This is a very hard task for someone who just, like I said, wanted to play as their favorite character. The bad thing here is that the fact that EA wanted people to feel like this was too hard. They offer microtransactions for people to just spend real money to unlock these characters. Basically, if you couldn't spend the time to unlock your character, it would be easier to just spend your money to unlock your character. Many people spoke up about this on Reddit, and the fans were not happy. Many people compared it to buying a car. They said, if I'm buying a car that comes with a stereo, I shouldn't have to pay for radio stations that I want. After all of this outroar over the horrible unlocks and microtransactions within this Star Wars game, EA lowered the price of certain packages, but still, this hasn't silenced the crowd. After this happened and the Madden franchise went down, EA saw many of their loyal customers leave. The fact that they didn't care about their buyers was super sad. If you thought that these examples were bad, just wait until you see what we have next. We talked about The Sims earlier on in this video. This game is loved by many people. I always love to get on and build a nice house. From a first glance, this game looks great and seems to be like a fun lifestyle simulator. But once we get into it, we can see that EA has created some major problems with this game. Let's look at The Sims 3. This game was released June 2nd, 2009. And remember, 2009 was around about the peak of EA games. So the fans were expecting this game to be great because all of the previous installments of EA games were amazing. The Sims is a series, and the game that came out before The Sims 3 was obviously The Sims 2. At that time, that was their best Sims game that they've ever released. Ever since the release of the Sims series, it's continuously gotten better. The original Sims was good, Sims 2 was great, and Sims 3 was planning on being amazing. And upon the release, it was amazing. It took everything from the previous games and added on awesome features that we would have never thought of. After that, the franchise steadily went up. With the release of Sims 3, EA was proving themselves as serious game developers. Throughout the lifespan of Sims 3, there were still new updates coming in quickly. This was the best Sims game we have ever had, and we could not wait for The Sims 4 to be released. Every year, with the new games, the graphics got better. The game was filled with more features and was just 10 times more fun than the last one. EA had an easy task to make Sims 4 good, and this was to carry over the last game and then add in a couple of new features that we always wanted. And upon the release of Sims 4, we got these new features, just not how we wanted to get them. On September 2nd, 2014, The Sims 4 was released. We quickly found out that the game was good, but felt a little too familiar. Some of the new features were included with the game, and some weren't. They were locked behind a paywall. Soon, this way of selling features would be EA's favorite way to sell content. Some of the features we remembered from The Sims 2 and Sims 3 were chopped up and made into DLC. Why in the world would they do this? The amount of money that they were seeking was crazy. The fact that we basically paid $60 for a Sims 2 copy and better graphics was crazy to all of us. We did not enjoy the game, but there was someone who did enjoy it. This person really, really, really loved this game, and that was EA themselves. By putting all of these old and new features into DLC packs, people had to buy it if they wanted it. No more free things. This was a money-grabbing simulator, not a life simulator. There were new additions to The Sims 4, but compared to the other years and just how much content was locked behind a paywall left us to wonder, why did this happen? EA seriously went from one of the most liked game studios to the number one most hated. There's only one thing to blame here, and that's themselves. Plenty of games such as FIFA 19, Battlefield 5, Madden 19, and Need for Speed have their own problems. For example, FIFA 19 is the same as Madden. They don't focus on the franchise mode or the career mode at all. They just focus on Ultimate Team. Battlefield 5 was poorly made, and Need for Speed has been the same for years now. All of these games that I just mentioned have ratings under 3. Once again, all of these games are under 3 out of 10. This is horrible, and to see EA games start really good and then fall off, that saddens me. I remember coming home and playing a whole bunch of EA games, and now I don't even play any of them because the money's gotten to their head. We can blame all of this on a couple of things. These things ruined the player's outlook on EA. One thing was the fact that they did not care about the player base. If we go back to the Madden series, I want to focus on RyanMoody21 on YouTube. He's been posting about the fact that EA is not fixing their game and continues to focus on the Ultimate Team game mode even when their game is suffering in every other aspect. He's been working towards this for years now, and I'm sure EA is not listening to him. Like I said, he's been, you know, protesting the fact that this game is horrible for plenty of years now, and I'm sure EA has heard about him or seen a video from him, but if they fix up their game, it's not gonna make them as much money as Ultimate Team will. So that's why they just really don't care. This brings up my other point, the love for money and microtransactions. Up until the year 2012, EA sold their game and that was it. No extra content, no nothing. The only money that they got was straight from sales. This was fun for us, but we felt like we wanted more from our games. So we asked for more content, but they made us pay extreme amounts through DLC and microtransactions. Obviously, game studios that are producing games every single month need money. EA is gaining this money that they need by doing some pretty weird things. If you look at Epic Games, for example, they're releasing skins for you to buy and releasing battle passes that you can buy for a cheap price. And this is so that they can keep releasing updates to their games. This is the complete opposite approach that EA does. EA does not care about anything other than money. Now, EA isn't a horrible game developer, but I just want you to realize that what they've been doing is not good at all. The fact that they can still produce really fun games is good, but seeing that games that they released 10 years ago are better than games that they're releasing today is really, really sad. Like, Madden 08 is 10 times better than Madden 18 was. And that's sad to me because the amount of technology and the amount of potential that EA could have is astounding, but they don't use it. The focus of this video is to make you look at EA as a bad game developer and to realize how much they don't care about any of their fans.